You're still here, yay! Great, it is a beautiful day outside today. Well done, Melbourne. Great, let's just do it, shall we? Hey, thank you again for your messages, by the way, and the photos, which are awesome. Please keep them coming, they're really cool. And it's, you know, it helps my my feelings of solitude, and that I'm, you know, just warming up for my iPad every day. Great, so I hope you're all feeling okay. Remember to self-moderate, remember just do what you are capable of, whether it's doing less, smaller, slower, or if you want to do more, you know, knock yourself out. Not literally, don't actually knock yourself out. I won't be liable if you do, by the way. All right, let's go for the playlist for day 5, starting with feeling good. 3, 2, 1, go. Hip width apart and just sinking down. Take a moment before we even start just to find your center, just to note where you're tight today. It might not be even on both sides. And now just lift up the toes, spread them out. Heels going backwards and downwards into the floor. And today we're going to start from the head up. So the back of the head lifts, rises, the chin slightly tucks. You can just release the neck. And just feel like that earlobes are melting down the sides of the throat. And you have a sense of that the larynx is smiling, so it's open and soft. And again, let this have a reflex somewhere else in the body. Just try and be receptive to that. Now, there's a whole bunch of tension that could be stored here. So if I get your finger in, sort of massage, there should be a little cheeky spot in here that really hurts. If you want, just pushing it for a bit. A nice trigger point. Breathe through the pain. And you can hold that for longer, not on here if you like, anytime. And just let it go. Just massage it out with your knuckles. And just find the sore point on the other side. Push into it. Might feel remarkably uncomfortable. Might even make you feel sick. Not that I encourage you to feel sick, but you know, work within your limits. Good. There might be another cheeky spot underneath here, around here somewhere, where if you push into it, it's going to really hurt. I'm not encouraging you to feel pain, by the way. I'm just finding trigger points to release. So dig your fingers into that. If you have a foam roller, this is a fantastic spot to find and to lie out on. Same with the one in the front. A bit hard with a foam roller, but with a spiky ball against the wall is quite good. Or a tennis ball. Good, let go of that. And just find it on the other side. Keep the knees nice and soft. Good, and breathe deep. Don't forget to breathe nice, deep down into the abdomen. So while you're here, you can still let the butt cheeks soften, let all the thighs soften. Good, and just have a feel what that's done now to the shoulders. Lovely, so the throat's expanding, particularly over this area, it's softening. So you can feel like the air in the room is just blowing through you. It's not like air molecules, you, internal you. It's all one continuum of molecules. And the sternum softens down until it reaches the small of the back. Now, if you imagine your heart's held up by heart strings, loosen them so the heart can sink down in the chest. And have the feeling that the area under the ribs is melting down to touch the wings of the pelvis. And that here and here you're expanding forwards and back. And in fact, sideways as well. And let the small of your back expand until it touches the back wall. And as you do that, really think about relaxing those muscles over the butt cheeks. And loosening the belt here. So you can imagine you've been wearing a tight corset and someone's just taking it off and everything can just hang out. Now really float your mind into the area around the pelvis. And try and see if you can visualize in your mind, you know, where these muscles attach in, how tight it is. And maybe these ones coming up here and over the butt cheeks, over the sacrum at the back. And just think about loosening those strings again. And now the thighs, you can imagine they're hollow. For some reason in my mind, I also imagine there's nice fluffy white clouds floating around inside, but they're hollow. And the meat on the bone over the calves can just sink down. So if you imagine you have a dot on the surface of your forehead and on the surface of your chest and in a dead center of your abdomen on the inside, those can align. But to do that, you need to relax down through the pelvis. So remember, don't pull it down. See if you can find that alignment through releasing. And if you're doing this in front of a mirror or a window that you can have a reflection in, you can just have a look and just see what instructions let your back start to release down so you get a bit more of a straight line rather than a banana bend. All right, keeping all that going on the inside in your own time, breathing in and out. So you can imagine the air is actually drawing up through the ground, through your feet, through your legs, into your abdomen. You draw it in. And then with your hands, just gently push it back out through the floor again. If you want to close your eyes, it's fine. I'm going to stay like this for a while. Softening the jaw. Match the movement with the breath. One more time. Good. Now float the weight into the ball of the left foot and sink down into it. As you sink down, the other leg rises up as you breathe in. As you breathe out, the heel comes down. Remember making that even square in front of you. Don't let the body rise and fall. So this leg is isolated. If you like, you can imagine someone's put a string on your knee. They pull it up as you breathe in. Heel goes down. Now unclench the butt cheeks, breathe in. Ball of the foot goes down. All of the weight should be in the ball of that grounded foot. Don't let it rock into the heel. Lifting up to the back of the head, spread open through the back of the neck. And let the air really inflate the belly and the back like you're a balloon on either side. Good, now that calf's getting a bit sore, so let's just place the foot back. Stay low and transfer the weight. Sit down now into that right foot, lifting up the left with the breath. Release the jaw, release the hips, breathing in and out. Remember, let the air of the room just blow through you like you're not even there. But you are, you're there, you're definitely there. I know you can start to doubt it in our current climate, but you are there. Let everything in your belly sink down through that grounded leg like sand. It's pouring down deep into the floor. Beautiful. Let's just change. Go back and sink down into the left foot again. And now we're going to circle. Doesn't have to be big this, but what I want to ideally have is I'm isolating this leg from the rest of the body, so it's not making me turn around like this. Again, my nice friend with a bit of string is just circling around. Now, you can engage your core here if you pull your belly button into your spine, and that will help you maintain balance. But instead, we want to find it through alignment. So sinking down through that grounded leg, weight in the ball of the foot, relax the butt cheeks, soften the jaw, soften the chest. Good, we're just going to change to the other side now. Breathing in. And out. Couple more times. Beautiful. All right, we're just gonna go into like a modified yoga sequence. Just roll out the shoulders. Might slightly massacre a salute to the sun. Just before we start, do the shoulders first and do the elbows. And open out the arms. Keep that breathing deep. Hopefully the legs should be feeling slightly buzzy. So what you want to do is now feel like you can relax so that lovely buzzy feeling goes through the whole body. Going forwards. Nice and easy. Beautiful into the elbows again. Actually, before we do this, sleep, just want to go a little wide with the legs. Again, as you bend down the knees, go out to the over the toes. So if you're finding this is happening, you can take a smaller stance. But we're going to lift up, and then your hand comes to your center. Now, the only reason why it looks like it's gone across my body is because I've turned my hips. So I'm not doing this. My hand's directly in front of my nose. So I'm going to go up and down. Then as I go up the other way, it's actually the drive through the floor that rises the arms. Breathing in and out. Breathing in. Keep going. So I'm turning from the hips, not the shoulders. Now we're going to go double time. So up. So this movement's all coming from the legs. So like the arms are just passive, go along for the ride. They get to turn because you're turning in the hips. Really drive through the floor. Beautiful. All right, taking this up to the end of the mat. And like I said, apologies to yoga people everywhere. Breathing in. And down. Now just hang here for a second. Feel like the muscles of your glutes are spreading. Knees are still soft. Now breathing in to inflate the spine and come up. Rising up. And down. So we're going to go breathing in. And down. Now I'm going to straighten the legs, look forward and lengthen. Breathing in, breathing out. One more of those. Breathing in, two, three, four, out. Two, three, rolling up. Two, three, four, and down. Now we're going to keep this on the count of four for a little bit. Just wait for it so I can time with my music. Don't know where you're at. Almost there. Much more satisfying with the music. Okay, breathing in for four. And out. Breathe in to look forward and lengthen. And breathing out. Breathing in to take yourself into a push-up position. Breathe out, take yourself down into a push-up. Don't touch the whole ground. Come back up again. And breathing out. Now, put your butt in the air, go into a child's pose. We're going to stay here for a bit. Good. Breathing in, we're going to scoot the butt through into an upward dog. And just stay here for a bit. Don't overstretch here. This is fine for you. You want to go into a cobra, that's absolutely fine. I don't do good yoga posture, by the way. So if you know better than me, by all means, please do better than me. Good. Tuck your toes under. Lift the butt straight to the end. Go into a down dog. And just start to walk out through here. Good. Creeping the hands to the feet. One more look forward and lengthen. And out. Rolling up. All right, we're going to rattle through this whole thing as one whole sequence to a count of four. So breathe in. Breathe out to go down. Breathe in to look forward and lengthen. Breathe out to go down. Breathe in to go into a push-up position. Breathe out to go down. Stay there. Breathe in to push up. Breathe out to go back down. Butt in the air. Breathe into a child's pose. Breathe out into an upward dog. Breathe in into a downward dog. And walking back in. Look forward and lengthen. Breathing in. And out. Rolling up to the spine. Breathing in. And down. One more time, straight into it. Off we go, breathing in. Breathe out to go down. Breathe in to look forward and lengthen. Breathe out to go back down again. Relax the head. Breathing into a push-up. Breathe out to go down. Breathe in to push back up. Breathe out to go down. Butt in the air to child's pose, breathing in. Breathe out into an upward dog. Breathe into a downward dog. And stay there. I told you I was going to massacre it. Alright, with your feet now, just take them out on a little bit of a journey. As you're walking through, you can cross them over. Just working, almost like you're trying to massage your ground, the ground with your feet. And you can again just start to get a bit of a twist through the body as you do this. Alright, now settle the heels on the ground. Lift the butt to the ceiling. Try and put your thighs on the back wall. Engage through the shoulder blades. Stretch out those calves. Good. Coming down to all fours. And check out your butt on the left-hand side. Back to center. And on the right-hand side. Back to center. One more time each side. You didn't quite see it properly the first time. And the other way. Good. Now just start to randomize the movement. So just sort of wiggle through like you're a three-year-old in a toddler's chair and you're just not quite comfy. Just randomize the movement. Try and look at every part of your body. So see if you can get behind your shoulder blades, underneath. See if you can look at all of the room now as you're doing it as well. Don't worry, no one's looking at you. Alright, lovely. So I just want to take you onto your side. And we're going to do some weird side push-ups, which don't feel like they're doing anything until your arms give out. Alright, so your hands just here. We're going to push up. So, up, two, down, two. Again. And again, and back down, last one, good, all right, just changing sides, and off we go, pushing up, interaction with my earphones cord. Yes, I do need the wireless buds, but I can't afford them, so that's not going to happen for a while. And up. Good. Good. Just come into sitting. And just rolling up those wrists. And the other way. Good, lifting it up and try and touch the wall. Keep the butt cheek on the ground. Lifting up, touch the other wall. And change again. And again. All right, now we're going to circle around. Good. All right, just taking ourselves now onto our back. Oh, to our side, sorry. And what you're going to do is keep the hips level. And it's like you're drawing a bow and arrow across your body. So you're going to bring this out, elbow to as far as you can go, and back in. So we go out, two, three, four, back in. Two, three, and again. You can go in your own time, of course. Couple more. And last one. Good. Just change the other side now. And same again. Out. Two,
Three, hello, plant. And back in. Making sure the hips are level. Don't let the hips roll because you want to get a little bit of that twist through the spine. Two more. Beautiful. All right, just coming up, we're going to hold a plank in this position. Just going to get a little bit comfy. So again, think long when you're holding this. Now, if you want to be a smart aleck, in this position, you can reach out and in. If you want to just hold the plank, that's completely fine. Try not to wiggle the butt too much. Make sure that, by the way, your elbows are placed under your shoulders. Keep holding the plank, keep holding it, keep holding it, keep holding it. Good, all right, take yourself into a child's pose. Just creep the fingers over to the left-hand side. And across to the right-hand side. Good. All right, just bring yourself. Now, if you can do this, you can get yourself into a bit of a squat like this. If that's not good on your knees, just come up a little bit. But otherwise, we're going to be here. So just give a little bounce. Now, if you want really good bang for your buck on this, actually pull your belly button into your spine. Tuck under your pelvis a tiny bit and engage your perineum. Engage it in towards the spine. Just to get a bit of a stretch along the small of the back. All right, good, hands down. And we're gonna lift the butt. So up and then back down. And again. Keep going. Good, just go up now. Shake that out while you're down there. Now reach as far through your legs as you can and pull back against it with the fingers on the floor. And now reach your fingers as far out as you can. And just relax, wiggle the hips. Good timing, sugar babes. Good, bend the knees, rolling up to the spine. Good, keep the legs wide and chest. Forward, center, right. Sorry, right to left. Just gonna turn my music up a bit because I like this song. Now front to back. So, forward, center, back, center. This seems to be the image that YouTube always takes of me is sometimes standing in horse stance. Okay, and now circle. Another direction. I was about to start singing and that would have been bad. All right, we're going to star. So, right. Back, left. Left, front, left. Again, front, left. Left, back. Back right. One more time without me saying it. And back the other way. All right, into the hips. You can be as cool as you like while you do this, but go a little lower now. Just to really engage those glutes. Stay down low, go front to back. As this starts to hurt, consciously think about the muscles softening and it widening. All right, if you need to break, come up for a second. If not, stay down. And we're gonna go into circling. As low as you can. And the other way. Smile through the pain. All right, good, coming up. We're just gonna gently swing forward to back. Just don't kick anything
behind you. Don't have to go to the music on this. But imagine there's a string on your foot that you're pulling with the opposite hand. Then you drop the string. Should turn my music down, I can't hear. Nice and easy, doesn't have to be high. Let gravity do the work and let the legs swing like a pendulum. If you really engage the arms, you can get a nice stretch across the body too. All right, good, other leg. Start nice and simple, nice and low. And pull on the string, let it go. Let the other arm work as well. Good, keep going. Good, all right. Gonna do circles again, but this time a bit more engaged than before. All right, off we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now go half time. 1. Go the other way. All right, other leg, starting off fast. Off we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now slow. Very nice. And go inwards. Really engage the core to help stabilize you here. Okay, good. Now we're gonna do what's called a runner's lunge. So keep all the weight on the front leg. What you're going to do is reach behind and touch with this toe. It doesn't go down, it just touches. Then you come forward and up onto this leg. So we go down and up onto the toe. Breathing in, breathing out. Each time you go back, try and go back a little further. So we're doing a dynamic stretch through that leg. Waiting for the beat to drop. And up. Should be getting a really nice burning sensation through that leg now. Last time. Good, shake it out. All right, other leg, same exercise. The screw bar waiting for the beat. Off we go. And up. Bad leg. Try and focus on something straight in front of you to help with the balance. Breathing in, breathing out. Four more. Good, shake that out. Good, I might just hold on to this. Just start to wave the arms above their head. And low. Like you're doing a crap version of flossing, and above. All right, now with a jump, a twist. And above the head. Hit yourself in the face with your apron cord. And above. Good, all right. Do this with the legs, so in, out, in. This is from Tom Hodgson. Make it as small as you can. Just dainty. Okay, middle size. And as big as you possibly can, sink right down low into it. Good, all right. We're gonna step and step behind. And just get the arms swinging with that. And bend right elbow, bend the knees, go low. Hope your mat doesn't slip. Go even lower. Okay, good. Now we're gonna change it to a reach across the body. So drive from this foot, so drive, drive. Keep going. Just go horizontal at the moment. Stretch the other hand out behind you. And And now diagonally up. Really feel the connection with the feet on the ground going down. Make a Spider-Man pose. All right, take out the weight shift. I'm just gonna twist. All right, slow it down now and go from foot to foot. Again, this is now our style aerobics. Good, all right. Just start to work yourself down and ease yourself down from one leg to the other. If you want to put your hands down, you can. And just sink down over one leg. This foot here, let's put it up like this for a second. And then put it down. Now, if you want to increase this stretch, lean in towards the center. This elbow, if you'd like, you can push that knee out slightly. If this is your limit, by the way, that's absolutely fine. All right, deep breath in and changing sides. Again, just put up for a second. And now place it down. Beautiful. Just change on the other side and go into a flexor stretch. Make sure this knee stays over your, not further than your toe. And if you want, you can give a slight wiggle there. If you can, you can put your elbows on the floor. If you can't, it's all good. Good. Hands down and changing sides. And just moving around a little bit. If you can, elbows to the floor. If not, by the way, this might be your stretch. That's absolutely fine. Okay, just gonna do a pigeon stretch. So put the leg in front of you across the body. Other leg goes behind and sit on the butt cheek. If you want to increase the stretch, this leg goes further out this way. If this is too intense, you can just sit and pull up the leg. Otherwise, if you can, you can bend over into it. Good, breathe in, breathe out, and just change the legs. Really nice. All right, back onto all fours and some cat cows. Lifting up and down. Breathing in and breathing out. Good. And this time, stay up there and just wiggle out the hips while you're up there. Good. Come back down. Go up. And stretch back until you find the stretch between the shoulder blades. Good. Coming back up. And just wiggle it out again. Good. Just take yourself into seating. Just nice and comfortable. This is about the arms, not the legs. Just take the arm across the body. This is the tricep stretch. So don't let this pull forward here. Keep the shoulders square. To increase the stretch, press up and in. It might have some sore triceps. Good, shake that out. And other arm. Good, again, to increase, go up and in. Beautiful. Just stand up, take yourself to a door frame, or in my case, a window frame. Just while the music's finishing here. And just gently take hold and just turn around till you find a stretch across the front here. Again, don't put yourself in any pain or discomfort. And the other way. It's a bit warmer today, isn't it? Well, actually depends on what day you're doing it. Actually, and which country. Just so you know, in Melbourne, it's a bit warmer today. All right, great. And then get a door frame or a window frame again. Just grab onto it. So stand near it and just pull yourself away so you can get a stretch up the side of the body. And away. Good. And just to finish, just want to get the head, just drop it to the side, give a gentle nod. Nice and easy. Keep the knees nice and soft. Just go back to going inside the body and recognizing where you're tense. Just roll the head around to the other side. Nod. And then just drop it to the chest. Put the hands behind. Let the weight of the arms just gently encourage the head to stretch. Coming up and just do a bit of a quad stretch on this side. Keeping those knees aligned. If you want to increase the stretch, feel like you're lifting up out of it so you can stretch through this hip. And just changing sides. Beautiful. Well, folks, that's week one. So I'm going to take a 2-day break for the weekend. Don't know why, it's not like days mean anything, but I will. So the next one will be in a couple of days' time on Monday. Until then, please keep safe, take care of yourselves, stay at home, and hope to see you all again next week. Thank you so much for your company this week. Lots of love. Bye-bye.